Welcome to the Shangwang Shooting Center for the second final of the day, 50-meter rifle, three positions women. We've kicked off the 2013 ISSF season with a completely new way of conducting the finals. For 50-meter rifle, three positions women, the top eight athletes after qualifications enter into the final after their qualification scores have been erased. The women begin in the kneeling position and shoot at three series of five shots in which they have 200 seconds per series to shoot. This is followed by a 7-minute break for the changeover in sighting time. They then move on to prone position and once again shoot at three series of five shots, but this time they have 150 seconds per series. A 9-minute break for changeover in sighting time will take place, and then the athletes move to the standing position. In the standing position, they have 250 seconds for the series, and there are two series in standing. At the end of the standing position, 7th and 8th place are eliminated, and they move on to single shots. There are five single shots, which are shot in the standing position. The athletes have 50 seconds for each shot, and after each shot, the athlete with the lowest score is eliminated up to the 44th shot, where we find out a bronze medalist, and after the 45th shot, the gold and silver medalists. I'm Hillary Russell, and have the pleasure once again to have USA's 2012 World Cup Final gold medalist, Jason Parker, here with us today. Welcome, Jason, and thank you for being here with me again today.
My pleasure. It'll be interesting to see how this brand new final works out. I think it's going to be a lot of fun, and I have no idea how it's going to turn out, but it'll be interesting, that's for sure.
And you'll be shooting in this the day after tomorrow.
Correct. I got two more days, and then we got our three-position competition.
Great, great. And so we do have a couple of young faces and some new faces, and we have a lot of experienced shooters as well, but it's been very interesting to see who's ending up in the finals this week.
It is, with all these new finals, same thing for the air rifle and the prone finals. It'll be interesting to see, you have a good mixture of the experienced, older experienced shooters and the new shooters, to see who adapts to these new finals a little bit better. So it'll be a lot of fun to see who comes out on top today.
That's true. And I even believe that we do have a woman here that doesn't even have a photo on her athlete's presentation. That's how new she is to this World Cup series. So let's take a look here. We have on firing point H, representing Germany, we have Sylvia Raquel. She just won the silver this week in 10-meter air rifle, but she's never entered into a final round of a World Cup before in this discipline. This is pretty impressive for her, you know, entering into two finals. She already won the silver in 10-meter air rifle. So let's see how she can do today.
Very good World Cup this so far.
Yes, in fact. And then we have in firing point G, representing Serbia, Ivana Maksovic. She was a silver medalist at the Olympic Games in London, and but she has never entered into a final round of a World Cup before. And that is, yes, she entered in 13th at one point, but that's it.
Again, a great young shooter that, like you said, won the silver medal in Beijing, or in London.
Yeah. Then we have on firing point F, representing Japan, Seiko Iwata. She's 32 years old. She placed 5th in Fort Benning in 2010 and 8th in Sydney in 2010. So it looks like she has taken a little bit of a break, and then she's back on to shooting for Japan.
Get the pleasure to meet her this February in the United States. She came out to Colorado and got to shoot a competition with her. Very good shooter, hard worker as well.
Great. Firing point E, representing the Republic of Korea, we have Yoon Kae-yoon Na. She placed 7th in Shangwang in 2005 during the World Cup. She also won the bronze medal during the Asian Games in 2006. Yoon Kae-yoon Na. No pressure there, huh?
We got two Korean shooters in here today. They're obviously the home favorites.
Obviously. Then on firing point D, another girl who has never entered into a World Cup ever. Her name is Hannah Shang, and she's 25 years old. We have really not a whole lot of other information on her.
These are the interesting shooters to watch and see how they handle the new finals format and see if they can adapt to it.
And she's really got nothing to lose. I mean, she's never, ever entered into any type of World Cup or international. Then, on firing point C, representing Sweden, we have Linda Olofsson. She placed 7th in London last year during the World Cup and 8th in Shangwon in 2011. On firing point B, representing Serbia, we have Andreja Arsovic, 26 years old, and she placed 6th in Fort Benning in 2011. And firing point A, representing the People's Republic of China, we have Li Beijing. She's 23 years old. She won the gold medal in 2011 in the World Cup in Shangwon. And she's a two-time bronze medalist during the World Cups in 2012 in Milan and in Fort Benning in 2011. So, Jason, once again, we start off with a score of zero. Everyone is, you know, neck to neck at this point. And it's going to be interesting to watch this because it's a little bit of a different format than, well, it's a big difference from the other formats.
A very big change. This is the first ever major international competition where we're shooting a final in all three positions. And so, you know, you got a time limit of 200 seconds for the 20 shot, for the 5 shots of kneeling. And it'll be interesting to see how the shooters adapt to this type of stuff and deal with the time limits, the wind changing, the new finals format, and once they get done with that, then they, you know, do a quick changeover, go into prone, and it'll be interesting to watch this whole final.
Well, let's get it started then. We're going to go into the first series here.
So one of the changes between last year and this year is we start shooting kneeling first of all. Mm-hmm. And so used to be prone where you get a little bit of a warm up in a stable position. Now you're moving up one. And so, you know, shooting kneeling for warm ups, which can be a challenge to some people.
Right.
You only have a small amount of time to get into your kneeling position and then it's time to perform.
And being in the kneeling position and then going into prone, that's probably not the, it used to be that you had standing in the middle.
Mm-hmm.
And so, is it more difficult to go from kneeling to prone, prone to standing? Or do you think, I mean, is there more tension in your shoulder? Is there more tension in your body?
For me, it's an easy transition because you're already going from one position with the sling to another position with the sling. There's a little bit of, you know, your hands get a little bit tired and all that kind of stuff. But really, you know, shooters are used to being in the position a little bit longer, so they make the transition pretty quick. But, you know, it flows pretty good this way because, you know, if you shoot kneeling right before standing, it's very difficult because you lose feeling in your leg, tingling and stuff. So, you know, it's logical that it goes this way. It's not so bad to change over.
We still have a minute and 40 seconds before this series is over. You know, when you count it out in seconds, it sounds so much shorter than if you look at it in minutes, you know?
It really is. You know, but it's easier to break it down that way and realize that you have 40 shots for each shot here in kneeling. And you know, really, that's plenty of time for kneeling here. But you're starting to see a little bit of the score discrepancies here, you know, big changes. And I think some of it is that pressure going into the kneeling first. And, you know, you want to get off to a real good start here because in prone, there'll be not so much of a change when the scores will be closer. And then moving to standing, you'll see a lot more changing in the rankings as well.
You can see there is a little bit of a breeze going on here. The flags are waving, or at least the distance flags are waving more so than the ones that are close up. And it's gotten really bright out.
Yeah, it was a difficult day on the range up there. It was cold, windy, very windy, and now it's starting to warm up a little bit more, but you can see the wind coming into the finals range here and really moving the wind flags around.
And it looks like Korea is doing a great job. We've got Na and Yang holding on to first and second place. Chang is about 1.8 tenths of a point away from Na. Arsovic is holding on to third place, only by 1/10 of a point. We still have another series of five shots.
So it's interesting to see the first series of kneeling coming up right now, because the scores are a little bit lower than what I was expecting, because kneeling is a fairly stable position, but you put a little bit of pressure into it. It's a very technical position where you have to pay attention to every single little thing, and you get a little bit of tension in there with your, whether it's your shoulders, your stomach, or something like that, and that rifle will start moving a bunch, and you're seeing some of that right now. And the Koreans off to a good start.
Yeah.
Already shooting some good tens down there.
You know, these are girls that we haven't really seen anything about in the past, so it'll be interesting. If they can get two of theirs, of their own on the podium, I have a feeling this finals hall is going to explode.
I believe so. It's, you know, a country, you know, spending the last week here, I realize, you know, they're real proud of their country, real proud of their country people. So I think it'll be great to see a couple of Koreans on the medal stand.
That's true. And they have been good to you, haven't they?
It has been a wonderful week. So.
Great.
Some good food, and met a lot of good friends here as well.
This is Na, who is holding on to first place.
Seems like the ladies have settled in a little bit now, starting to see a little bit better scores here in the second series.
I can imagine it can be, you know, quite unnerving to be entering into your very first, you know, final round of a World Cup. Or it could just be playing to your advantage, where you just think, you know, I've got nothing to lose. This is my first time. We'll see what happens.
Exactly. There's a lot of unknowns out there, and you come in here with without any expectations, like a brand new shooter, and you know, you got a young shooter, and they're very dangerous because they have no limits. You know, somebody who's been there and done that before, they have a preconceived idea of what they're expecting to do and all that kind of stuff. But those young shooters, they can be scary.
Just see absolutely no movement whatsoever.
You can see the Chinese girl there. She's already done with her series, but she's just trying to keep her muscles warm and relaxed by doing a little bit of dry fire and holding exercises. It also keeps you kind of focused on what you're supposed to be doing instead of putting the gun down and waiting in between shots and looking at the scoreboard.
Okay. Let's take a look now. Na still holding on to first place by 1.4 tenths of an advantage over Arsovic, who has moved up into second place. Maksimovic also has moved up the scoreboard. She's only 4/10 of a point away from Arsovic, and Olofsson is only 3/10 of a point behind her. We do have another series, and then we'll be moving on to the prone position.
So that series was much better. The first one, there was only one person above 50.0,
mm-hmm.
And on this one here, we have seven of them higher than that. And I always thought that when I'm in my training, that if you shoot a 51.0, that's about the score that you need to do to be successful here in kneeling, and it's looking like that's about where everybody's starting to have a bubble. We got mm-hmm. four scores up there on this one with a 50.8, another one 51.0. So anything around there. At the first one by Korea's Na, she had a 51.5. That's a really good score, I believe, in the kneeling position here.
Arsovic has moved up the scoreboard. Again, we've got two women from Serbia. It looks like we've got a little bit of a fight going on between the Serbians and the Koreans. You know, the Serbians are definitely putting the pressure on right now.
Yeah, it's a good race, and there's still a lot of people moving up and down the leaderboard right now. So I think the Koreans been in the lead from the get-go, but the other folks are catching up. The Serbians are catching up, and just watching the scoreboard, flip-flopping almost every single shot.
Now, like I said, Jason, after this series, then we'll have a seven-minute break for the changeover and the sighting time. Tell me a little bit of what they'll be doing during that time.
You know, it's a really cool type of thing. You know, right now you're trying to take your time, maximize the time limit that you have so you can get into a good rhythm of shooting. And immediately once they get done shooting the series, they're going to say stop, changeover starts now. And from that point, you'll have 7 minutes to change from kneeling into the prone position. And right then you go from a nice, you know, kind of a calm, relaxed type of state, and then you're trying to rush around, get all your equipment changed over so you can maximize your time and get more sider shots out of it. And so the changing of the speed from calm to the speed, then you have to slow yourself back down. It's a hard transition, but it's the one that the shooters are going to have to learn to master if they're going to be successful at this new final.
Yeah, we were saying that watching some of these men and women shooting, and during that time, it is you are under pressure, and there's some handshaking that goes on a little bit, you know. And we're watching some of the equipment dropping, you know, because they're just trying so fast to get everything together. So then they do have more time for sighting.
Exactly. And, you know, how the fewer adjustments you have on your rifle, the quicker it's going to be. But at the same time, you have to build a solid position that's going to be able to give you the support that you need to execute a good shot. So we got almost everybody done with their shots, and they're already thinking now about their transition into the prone position.
So it not only is it, you know, precision shooting, but it's also a real mental game as well of trying to get yourself prepared mentally to do this. Let's just take a look one quick moment at the scores. After the kneeling position, we have Arthovich, who has now moved up into first place. She is followed by Olofsson, who is only half a point behind. Na has moved down into third place. She's 6/10 of a point behind Olofsson. And Lee is 2/10 of a point behind Olofsson. So now we've got this 7 minute changeover, and mentally, from going to just, you know, trying to nail the bullseye as many times as they can, now they have to be thinking basically in a way of preparing themselves. And here we are back in the finals hall, and we've got the women that are preparing. They're doing sighting time for the prone position. Once again, we will have three series of five shots. This time, they will have 150 seconds per series to shoot. Now, it looks like it's quite challenging to change over.
It was. I was enjoying watching them change over and everything. The Chinese girl, she was the first person to lay down their position but didn't shoot a shot for a while. And then Iwata, she was the first one to shoot a sider shot. And I think it's very important to get a lot of sider shots down there just to get comfortable. And like I was saying earlier, you're changing from rushing around trying to get your equipment changed over. Now the athletes have to slow back down and get comfortable and lay down and shoot those sider shots just so they can get comfortable. Not necessarily get their zero, but get their positions fixed as well.
And I was taking a look at the clock, and the first shot was shot when there was only 3.5 seconds left. Not 3 minutes and 3 seconds left. Mm-hmm. So you can see that it does take some time for them to settle in, and that doesn't leave them with a whole lot of time. 3 minutes and 30 seconds to do sighting time is...
That's correct. I mean, you know, I thought the changeovers were fairly quick today, but I think the last shooter got down in position. They only had 2 minutes left for their sighter shots. So someone in that position, they're going to have to speed up their transition and find ways to save time and get down there a little bit quicker, you know, because every 20 or 30 seconds in prone is another sighter shot, which really helps out in the confidence of the shooter. Going in there knowing your position is good and you're sighted in, you've got a real good zero anyways.
Let's just keep in mind now about the scores. We have Arcevic holding on to first place by 0.5 over Olofsson. Na is 0.6 point behind Olofsson, and Lee is only 0.2 point behind Na. Again, we've got three more series in the prone position before we move on to the standing position.
So in the prone position, I don't think there'll be a whole lot of changing positions around. There'll be some, obviously, but the next big opportunity to pick up points is going to be those first two series in the standings. Mm-hmm. You know, that's where you're going to see a lot of people move back up and stuff. Because, you know, maximum, you might be able to pick up 1, maybe 1.5, 2 points on somebody in the prone position. But standing, you can make up a point on each shot if somebody shoots a good 9 and you shoot a really good 10, that's 1 point right there. So you don't get that so much here in prone. You'll not a whole lot of moving going to go around.
Rich is currently holding on to first place. It's pretty impressive, some of these scores right now. We've got to see some 10.8s, 10.7s.
Yeah, it's nice to see that, you know, you make that transition, you settle in, and you start shooting really good. Olofsson, her first two shots is a 10.8 and a 10.7. That's going to be a real confidence builder. So, and those kind of shots, those are the ones going to move you up the leaderboard.
Back on now to Na, who was, after the kneeling position, she was 0.6 point away from second place.
Then Olofsson, she just shot another 10.7. That's a fantastic series right there. And another 10.5.
Unbelievable.
As far as
definitely on a game here.
As far as prone goes, I think a good series would be somewhere between a 42.0 and a 42.5. That's the goal that you're going to be trying to shoot here in these finals and everything. And she's well above that. Right now, you know, averaging almost a 10.6. Mm-hmm. Yeah, she's finished up with a 52.8, which is that's moving a long ways in that scoreboard.
And she has put the distance between herself and Arcevic. Olofsson is in first place by 1.6 tenths of a point. We have Arcevic in second place. Lee is 0.4 point behind Arcevic. Chang has moved up the scoreboard. She was down a little bit low, but she's 1.3 tenths of a point away from third place. And her teammate, Na, is 0.4 point away from her. It's really, really close right now. And, you know, Raquel, she's got to really focus in. She had a couple good shots, but, you know, we're going to be going from this into standing, so she's got to start shooting a little bit deeper, but she's a new girl, you know. She has nothing on her athlete's presentation.
Exactly.
And so, yeah.
You know, you got to wonder what's going through her mind right now, you know. Hopefully she's out there and enjoying herself and having fun, but, you know, the scores, you know, for that first series of prone, we're not all that great. They're average, but mm-hmm. It's not an easy day out there with all the wind going on inside of this finals hall. But the 52.8, that'll really, really separate you out here. And let's see how she does on this series.
Starting off, Raquel with a 10.3.
You can see, if you're watching the screen right now, her muscles are going up and down. She's using her breathing to kind of calm down and get prepared for this shot.
9.7. Max Simovic is really having quite a good series. She's 2 into the 5 shots, coming off of a 10.3.
Good solid There's position, and again, you can see how she's breathing, kind of calm herself down. You can see the barrel go down a little bit and back up.
Iwata. With a 10.3.
Olofsson's second series was pretty decent with a 51.9, but Andrea Arcevic, 52.5, with an excellent score.
Yeah,
they are better in this one. Jang is a 52.3, much better series for the girls on this one.
Yeah, Olofsson is still holding on to first place. Arcevic is definitely putting the pressure on her. She's 1 point behind Olofsson. Lee in third place by 1.7 tenths of a point. And Jang and Nat are very, very close behind.
Right now, all the scores are really close. And you got one more series here in prone to kind of help yourself out a little bit. But really, it's, you know, when you get that standing, that's where a lot of moving is going to go on. And right now, the scores are close enough that anything can happen in standing.
Now, in your opinion, personally, what is the most difficult position for you?
You know, they all have their own intricacies and everything, but kneeling is traditionally been the tougher position of mine. It's just very technical, and you know, getting a position that's solid that can hold up under pressure is the key with the kneeling. So, but other people standing because it's the most unstable and it moves around a little bit more, but. Obviously, prone is one of the easier ones. They got the higher scores, but again, you know, it's an opportunity to shoot good tens and move up the leaderboard, and you can't give anybody any room in this sport anymore. So you got to take advantage of it and do the best you can in all three positions.
Kind of a 9.8. She's shooting in the high nines to finish off her last series here. Let's take a look at her teammate, Na. With a 10.3.
You can really see how well they're concentrating and working through this kind of stuff with their breathing, and I guess a good indicator of the shot is how well they follow through, because a lot of times you shoot a bad shot, you're not going to follow through as good. So after they shoot, you can see how long they hold that position, and Nah, she has she's really following through really well and doing well.
Back on now to Maximovic. She's having a pretty good series here. Coming off of a 10.6 right now.
That's a minimum where you want to be. If she has a good 10 on this one, it's going to be a fantastic series for her.
10.2 finishing up.
Stop. Unload.
So let's take a look here. This is after the prone position. We have Olofsson still in first place. She's lost a little bit of her lead. She's in holding on to first by 7 tenths of a point, followed by Arcevic. Lee is in third place with 2.1 tenths of a point disadvantage from second place. Na is in fourth place, and she is 2.2 tenths of a point. We're going to be moving on to the standing position, and we've got two series there, and then we'll go into the single shots.
Yeah, ladies and gentlemen. Now, ladies and gentlemen, the chief range officer has given his 9 minutes change over time, and the athletes will change the equipment again into the starting position. 9 minutes.
And we're back again now for the two series of five shots during the standing position. Jason, we just saw this changeover. It was really quite interesting to see the differences that they did, the things that they did to get ready for this position. And you were talking a little bit, saying that standing can be a little bit more difficult because you're not stable.
It is. It's the highest center of gravity, so you're going to be moving around the most. And it seems that the shooters, most of them prefer either kneeling in prone or they like standing. And so this part here, you're really going to see the standing shooters shine and make some big moves here in this little bit, because kneeling, so far it's all been with the sling position, and most people that like the slings, they're up at the top of the leaderboard. But it really takes all three positions to be good here, and the standing is the hardest, most difficult one because of the high center of gravity. And then at the same time, you get the pressure on there, you can be moving around them more, and you can see a bigger change of position. So this is where the standing shooter is going to make their move up the leaderboard and maybe overtake some of the people that only like shooting in the sling positions.
And once again, what we did is we have two series of five shots. The shooters have 250 seconds for each series. And after the second series, position 7 and 8 will be eliminated. We'll be moving on from there to single shots, which are shot in the standing position. And the athletes have 50 seconds for each shot. And after each shot, the athlete with the lowest score is eliminated. We'll just have about 15 more seconds of sighting.
In the prone and kneeling position, balance is very important, and it's one of the things you focus on. But when you get up into the standing position, that's the main thing which you have to look at. Have a comfortable position and really good balance. And so when you get in a pressure situation, that's one of the things that some of the athletes will overlook. And so it'll be interesting to see how these guys handle how these ladies handle the pressure and shoot these next two series.
Now, in your opinion, Jason, 250 seconds, is that quite a bit of time?
250 seconds it's not a lot of time. I'm a fairly quick shooter, and I push that time limit. Stop. So if you're a slow shooter, you're going to have to really pick up the pace and, find ways to shoot on the first hold or whatever. There's no time to take a second hold if you pick the rifle up and it's uncomfortable. Normally during a competition, you have plenty of time. You can put it down, you can start all over. But in this type of situation, you have to find a way to shoot a 10 on that shot, even though it might not be perfect when you're holding the rifle.
Focusing in on Raquel, she's starting off with a 10.6. She really has got to shoot nice and strong, because she is one of the women that could be eliminated after the second series. But a 10.6, then followed by a 10.2 is going to move it right up the scoreboard.
Now you're already starting to see where those 10.5s and 6s are really helpful, because we got a couple athletes up there. Their first shots were 8.5, 8.8, and so that's a 2-point swing right there, just in one shot. You can really see people moving up and down the board right now, and the stronger standing shooters are going to continue to move up.
And that's the thing, you shoot in the eights, and that is just enough to bring you right down to eighth place. And that's a lot of pressure.
It is, yeah. A lot of things going on. You got the wind going on down there, the pressure of being in the finals and everything, and it all comes together right now. And you have to have a lot of confidence in your ability to execute a good shot under these conditions.
And Chang, who is having a bit of a difficulty starting off on this series, things are going to change around for her where she's standing.
Yeah, she's going to have to realize that those shots are downrange. You can't take them back. There's nothing you can do about it. And at this point, all you can do is execute your next 8 shots as good as you possibly can, not try to make them absolutely perfect. Mm-hmm. A lot of people try to overcompensate and try to shoot a perfect 10.9 on every shot, but you have to stay loose enough and just, you know, aim for the 10 ring, and where it goes in the 10 ring is up to the shooting gods, I suppose. You know, but you just can't think about those shots that are already down. There's nothing you can do about them.
Now with a 9.8. Andrea
Arcevic there with a 49.5, which is an excellent score for this series. I was saying earlier that a 51.0 is what I try for kneeling, a 52.0 to a 52.5 in prone. 50.0 is a good goal to have here in standing, and she was right there at a 49.5. Same here for Maximovic.
And in fact, Arcevic, as you were saying, has shot a very strong series there. She has now overtaken Olofsson by 2.4 tenths of a point, leads in third place, only 4 tenths of a point away from Olofsson. Let's take a look at our 7th and 8th place. We've got Sylvia, Raquel, and Chang that are holding on to 7th and 8th places right now. 2.5 tenths of a point, Yang is an a disadvantage. What do you think about that? Can you get out of that in the next?
2.5, you can't get out of that, but you need some help from the shooters in front of you.
Mm-hmm.
But really, there's, you know, between Sylvia Rockel and Saiko Iwata, there's only a tenth of a point there. If it was a tenth of a point or 1 point, I can see a swing there.
Mm-hmm.
2.5 point, that's going to be difficult to overcome.
And so we really need to take a look then at Raquel, Iwata, and Na that are very, very close in their scores. One of those three, or if something awful happens to the front runners, will be eliminated, as well as Chang.
So this is the shooter's last opportunity to make a big move. After this series of shots, we're going to go into one shot series, just the single shots, and it's more difficult to move up. And those gaps get the bigger gaps are harder to overcome. But in this five shot series, you can pick up a point, you know, maybe 2 points or so. And so this will be the last opportunity for a big move for these shooters.
Arcevic starting off the 10.5. over Olofsson's 9.4. Again, Raquel 9.9.
Pei Ching Li 10.7. That
nice.
Put her all the way up into the second place right now.
That's the whole thing. And just one deep shot, and you just shoot yourself right up the scoreboard.
Mm-hmm.
Again, on to Chen.
You can see she's not all that happy right now with her standing position. Gonna have to find some kind of modification to make, because she's gonna finish up strong in these next three shots.
Iwata. She's coming off a 9.4.
Got some really good shooting going on here by Andrea Arcevic and Pei Ching Li.
Mm-hmm.
Some excellent scores right now, 41.3 and a 31.3. Be nice to see how they finish up in these next couple shots, but those are excellent starts to the series and really going to separate themselves from the rest of the pack.
Olafson just coming off of a 7.5. I'm curious of what happened right there. You know, she was holding on to first place for quite a while there, then down to second, and 7.5 is not going to help out her standings. Like you said, Arsovich, fantastic series there. You could tell she was very pleased with it as well.
Exactly. Wow, finished up with a 10.8.
Yeah.
52.1. That's huge. That's why she's at the top of the leaderboard right now. That one of those series just like that, it's fantastic.
And Olafson finishing off with a 10.2.
It's always really nice to see athletes have good series like that and get rewarded for it as mm-hmm. well. And she's got quite a big lead over second place right now. Olafson right now holding on to that third place, so she got to really concentrate on this shot. You see her settling in and letting her position get really nice and comfortable.
And she finishes off with a 9.8.
Yeah, ladies and gentlemen.
And the unfortunate thing of the day is that both of the Koreans will be eliminated from this final. To Na and Chang from the Republic of Korea, both of them with not a whole lot of experience, but making it into the final says a lot for their future. You know, they maybe two women that we have to keep our eyes on a little bit. It's too bad for Korea and the audience here, because I'm sure they would have loved to have
exactly.
them on the podium.
That's a tough one here in front of the home crowd. But you know what? They're young and showing potential to do really well here in the future.
So we're going to be going on now to single shots. And there's going to be five of them. And after each shot, someone will be eliminated. Well, let's take a look here. We've got Iwata is holding on to sixth place right now. 2-point difference between herself and Raquel. So something drastic is going to have to happen.
Yeah, it looks like
keep her in.
Looks like Iwata will be the next person to go out. 2 points is a big difference. You can make it up in one shot, but it's difficult. You need to have a lot of help from the other people on the firing line. But what's really interesting is fifth through third place.
Yeah.
They're only separated by 0.2 of a point for a bronze medal, and another 3 shots to go before those are that's decided.
Focusing in here on Iwata. Finishing up with a 9.6. Raquel with a 10.7. So let's take a look here. Sixth place, Iwata. She will be eliminated and will be going on to find out who's going to be in fifth place. Arsovich holding on to first place by 3.3 of a point over Lee. Raquel has now moved up into third place, and she's holding that only by 0.2 of a point.
So you saw that one. Iwata obviously had a 9.6 and was eliminated, but Olafson, a 9.3, and all the other shooters picked up over a point. The next closest shot was a 10.3 on that one shot, so that's a huge swing in just that one there, and it goes to show that if you want to be the best in these finals, you have got to shoot 45 quality shots to make it all the way up there to the top, because that one shot right there was huge, and now she's looking at having to make up 1 point in one shot over some extremely talented shooters.
Start. Yeah, the fact she was holding on to first place for such a long time, too.
Mm-hmm.
But she was still shooting very strong, a 9.3 for Olafson.
Stop.
And in fact, it's not going to happen for Olofsson today. She will be eliminated from the final. And now we're going to be taking a look at Raquel, Maksimovic, Lee, and Arasovic. Arasovic is still holding the first place. And she hasn't changed her standings. It's still 3.3 tenths of a point. Lee holding on to second place. Maksimovic in third, and 3 tenths of a point behind is Raquel. So this is very...
This is what I was talking about earlier. Right now we have some of the shooters that had the highest series of shots, and you know, the standing shooters is what I refer to them as. They're really starting to move up and get in there, and you can see Maksimovic is the calm, cool confidence that she had at the Olympic Games right now, and she's moving all the way up there, just with the standing position. So we got a good race here for the bronze medal with only 3 tenths of a point separating him.
Start.
Again, back on to Lee.
Let's see, excellent technique there. Good balance. She's just letting her muscles relax into the position, and when it's perfect, and the sights are aligned. Some good follow through on there.
Gives her 10.
Excellent shot.
Five, yes.
Wow.
Unbelievable. Absolutely unbelievable. A 10.2 was not enough for Raquel to stay in the final. Great shooting from her. She's already been on the podium one time this week. I'm sure she wanted to be on it again. We'll be moving on now for the bronze. This is between Maksimovic, Lee, and Arasovic. It seems like it's kind of done, the bronze.
It is. Yeah, there's a lot of separation now. Four points to move up into second place, another 2.5 to move up into first place. You know, these last couple shots are, there's a lot that can happen on them, but this is the position they should end up in. But what a great shootout there for the bronze medal between Rockel and Maksimovic. Both of them firing tens on the last shot, and that's what you want to see when you're looking at athletics. You want to see somebody who's going up there and you beat them on their best day. You don't want to beat someone when they're not shooting at their best. And both gave it their all, and that's the way it turned out. It was a great fight for the bronze medal.
That's a nice way of putting it, actually, Jason, to beat them on the when they're having a good day, you know?
Exactly. I've been beat on good days and beat on my bad days, and when people point out, ooh, they beat you on a bad day, it's not good.
Oh.
Well, there we go. We got some interesting stuff here. Already in the medals at 6.9.
I did not see that coming.
An
8.6 and a 10.6 for Maksimovic. Unbelievable. Unreal.
Well, that was certainly interesting.
That was. Finishing off with a 10.6 and the bronze medal. We've got something huge going on now for the silver and gold. But once again, there's our bronze medalist, Maksimovic. Great way to finish off the shot with a 10.6.
Fighting all the way to the end, but
that's
just
right.
Not good enough. And now we got a real close game going on here. 7 tenths of a point between the gold and the silver medal. That 6.9 and an 8.6. Wow.
What do you suppose is going through her head right now, Jason? It's already done. Basically, we can wrap it up. We could just stop commentating right now because I already know it's going to be gold, silver, and bronze. But. A 6.9.
Well, right
what
now,
in the world?
Right now, they just got to be focused on a recovery and executing the best shot that they possibly can, because those two shots right there, they'll rock anybody's world. And you just got to calm down and focus on shooting one quality shot right now.
Well done. For Arasovic, very nicely done.
And so at this point, she's going to need a 10.8 to tie her, which is a really difficult shot in standing position. Yeah.
Anisovic, she did it. She won the gold medal. There she is, our gold medalist today. Andreja Arsovic from Serbia winning the gold medal, overtaking Li Peking. Excellent way to finish up for Andreja Arsovic. She looks a little bit shocked, actually, Jason.
It does.
She does. She has that shell-shocked look about her.
There's days that you're just happy you run out of bullets before the next person catches you, and that's kind of the way this was. But you know, she recovered from that shot really well and did really good. Great final.
Great final indeed. Thank you once again for joining us today. I grabbed you out of the audience at the very last second. Once again, let's just take a look at this. That's Andreja Arsovic, gold medalist for 50-meter rifle, three positions woman. And our silver medalist, Li Peking, from the People's Republic of China, winning the silver medal today. Great shooting. She put up a good fight. And as we know, we've seen our bronze medalist, Maksimovic. And again, Jason, thank you so much for joining us. I wish you the best of luck in a couple of days when you are going to be doing your own final.
Thank you.
And,
my pleasure.
Yeah, all right.
Ladies and gentlemen, the medal ceremony for 50 meters rifle three positions women's event, ISSF World Cup Champion 2013, will now take place. The medals will be presented by Mrs. Chisrae Briez, the chairman of the classification jury. She is accompanied by Mr. Wataru Fuji, the rifle jury member. The bronze medal, with a final score of 442.5, representing Serbia, goes to Ivana Maksimovic. Gold medal with a final score of 455.5, representing Serbia, goes to Andreja Arsovic. we're going to have a short time for commemorative photo with the medalist and the presenter.